Hello students, welcome to the class on editorial Decode, and in this class I will be dealing with today's lead editorial, and this is about recapitalization of banks. First of all, we need to understand the word capitalization, and then we need to understand the word recapitalization of banks. Now, capitalization of banks means that the banks have the sufficient funds to provide it in terms of loans to the people. Now, why it is important that the banks should have the sufficient capital? Now, without the capital, it will be very difficult for the borrowers to borrow from the banks. And if they will not be borrowing from the banks, in that case, they will not be able to put it in the economy. If they will not be able to put it in the economy, and the new ventures will not be set up, the new investment will not be done, in that case, the economy will not move forward. So it is important that the capitalization should be done. Now, what is the meaning of recapitalization? Now, recapitalization means that the government deliberately is pumping in the money in the banks. The government deliberately is providing the money to the banks. And why there is a need to recapitalize the banks? The need has arisen because of the factor that the banks have given a lot of bad loans to the people. Bad loans. Now, because they have given a lot of bad loans to the people, to the corporate sector, they have not returned it back. And now the bank is actually short of money. Now, because the bank is short of money, it is very important that the government should be actually filling its coffers. Now, if their coffers will be filled, they will provide loans to the private players. And it is the private players that who will be setting up the ventures. And through these ventures, the employment will be generated. So through credit, the ventures will be set up. Through ventures, the employment will be generated. And when the employment will be generated, it will also result in generating the growth. So growth, employment, setting up a venture, it is all related to the investment that will be done by the people, by the corporate class. And this corporate class and the people can do the investment only if they will have access to this capital. And they can have to the capital only if the banks will have the capital. Now presently the banks, they are not having the capital because of the past mistakes. Now the important word here is past mistakes. So what kind of past mistakes? Now, when the global economic crisis took place or unfolded in 2008, the banks were in anticipation that this crisis will not be long-term crisis, and it is important that they should be continuously providing credit to the corporate class, because in case of India, the economy was doing very good in the years 2008, 2009, and 2010. So the banks never had an idea that there will be a slowdown in the Indian economy in the years to come. So it was always thought that the Indian economy has not been affected by the global economic crisis. But this belief system of RBI, of the banks, did not turn out to be true. Now, all the corporates who had borrowed the money, the credit from the banks, they had set up their ventures. But these ventures, they had failed. So the anticipation of the banks turned out to be false. Because their anticipation was false, has turned out to be false. The banks got decapitalized. And therefore, the need has arisen to capitalize the banks again. Now, the author has actually gone into the details why the banks have fared so badly on the front of non-performing assets. Now, the first reason that has been put forward is about the lack of the governmental clearances and basically the environmental clearances. Now, all the ventures that were set up, that had borrowed the money, they had failed to get these environmental clearances. And because of that, their investment had not yielded much. Jo paisa liya hua tha, clearances nahi mila, toh project ne zyada paise nahi diye. And second is because of the coal allocation. Jo bhi coal licenses diye hue the, unko denotify kar diya Supreme Court ne. And the same thing has also happened with respect to the spectrum issue. So a lot of the companies, they have actually failed because of these corruption issues. And these are the two potent reasons why the banks could not get back their money. And thirdly, the reason was actually the slowdown in the global economy. So these were some of the factors that have also a relationship to the reforms, the impending reforms that the government should be bringing in. Because if the government will not be bringing in the reforms, in that case, this class, the corporate class that is setting up the ventures, will not be able to yield the output and the return. Until the time the output and the return will not be coming, they will not be able to pay back the loans. But now the opposite has been done. The government has given this fiscal stimulus. The keyword here is fiscal stimulus. Now the fiscal stimulus has been given by the government to the banks. Now the government has provided them with the rupees 2.11 lakh crore rupees. But this amount will do little to this ailing sector, the ailing bank sector. Now reason why? Because the banks, they require huge amount of money. Already in the past, under Mission Indradhanush, government already capitalized the banks in the past. But iska koi result, substantive result nikal ke samne nahi aaya. Kyun nahi aaya? Because the problem of the banks is not related to, confined to the banks itself. It is also confined to the other sectors of the economy. So government needs to actually unleash its impending reforms. A clearances, jitne bhi projects atke hue hain, unko jaldi se jaldi clearances dena chahiye. Aur jitna bhi corruption hai, set up ho rakha hai, वो भी खत्म होना चाहिए. और बैंकों का जो एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन है उसमें इंडिपेंडेंस होना बहुत जरूरी है. जो बैंकों के डायरेक्टर है, अभी क्या है, थोड़े से पैसे के लिए बैंकों के डायरेक्टर क्या करते हैं, किसी को भी लोन दे देते हैं और लोन बहुत बड़े अमाउंट में, 200 करोड़, 300 करोड़, 400 करोड़, और वो फिर वापस नहीं आता है. और इस तरह का लोन देने के लिए एक्चुअली मजबूर किया जाता है. मजबूर कैसे होते, क्योंकि जो बैंकों का सारा सिस्टम है, the structuration of banks, it is actually under a lot of political influence. So political influence ko hume khatam karna padega. Usko khatam karne ke to hamara jo banking sector hai, ye actually strengthen hoga. Jab banking sector strengthen hoga, tabhi hamara economy strengthen hoga. Ye sector kharab means entire economy kharab. So this was all for the editorial decode. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is Brainy IAS. Now for any sort of query, if you have about civil services preparation and about joining our online classes or buying video class packages or buying or joining offline classes, you can visit brainyies.com or you can send your query at my WhatsApp number, that is 8459400000. So this was all for the day. Bye bye, take care, have a nice day.